think it was that kind of felt My Bloody Valentine loop and Primal Scream. I used to love them.
Screamadelica is an amazing album. It introduced dance and techno to a whole new crowd.
Bass, repetitive bass style.
That's what moves you.
You don't need anything more quite often.
I think that's why the track Bobby's so strong. It's just so simple, the sounds in it, and then it's stripped down so much.
At our gigs, we use projections to underline the sound. The sound and the visuals together help to create the power of the live performances. It's more than just music. Our gigs are supposed to blow your mind. To create these visuals, we work closely with Lazy Eye, Spencer Booley, and Izzy Klingles.
These be the loops. There are lots of little pictures that when you run them through a projector, they'll show a looping image for about 5 seconds. Very small ones like that, which is about 3 seconds. No, it's about 2 seconds. It's about 5 seconds. And then you mix them all up and create something more.
The avant-garde filmmaker Kenneth Anger was an influence on Lazy Eye in many ways. In his films, I especially like the rawness and the erotization he portrays.
The visuals become like kind of as important, you know, are as important as the music, you know, for us. And that's probably mainly just down to the fact that we don't have that front bus and we need something for people to focus on to.
The artwork for this backdrop is influenced by Harry Smith. Smith was also the influence when Spencer came to India with us to do the video for Neptune City. We took our inspiration from this new method of animation Smith developed, hand painting directly onto film. In this piece, called Early Abstractions, you can see how he animates different geometric symbols. Harry Smith died, like many other famous artists, in the Chelsea Hotel in 1991. Kenneth Anger's Scorpio Rising is probably the most widely seen underground movie. Its heroic vision of urban youth culture, homoeroticism, and blasphemous use of Hitler and Christ images makes it disturbing and brilliant in the same time. Thank you. Scorpio Rising gave inspiration for a project, Claiming Marilyn. Claiming Marilyn is a collaboration of different designers and reprobates. And in this instance, it was Fearless, Bevan, and Emily Hell.
What captivated me was the image on the sleeve of the sort of, you know, hobbled foot in the club foot in the shoe, and it just seemed really obvious that the first place it should be played is in the dungeon.
The whole thing with the artwork, what I was trying to do is like kind of have that kind of repetition of an image, like kind of quite harsh image, but it's kind of like almost quite sadistic. And repeat it, but with that repetition have a slight change. And so you look at each actual kind of x-ray of the shoe and it is very, very different. And when we do a lot of our artwork, it's that we'll come up with an idea and then we kind of, like the sucker pieces, the actual pieces, you know, the pawn pieces. And, you know, we kind of designed them and then we kind of gave them out to these, you know, different printers, and we wrote with different printers. And it's like, you know, people like Jeff Koons, like where they work, it's just like, that's the way forward, I think. You know, the days of just painting something, you know, and just like, it's about just involving other people, but utilising the talent around you, I think, to a certain extent. I think my kind of getting into kind of, well, reggae really originally was like being on a bus when I was a kid and finding a tape, this cassette tape, and had nothing written on it, and I took it home and listened to it, and it was a reggae album, and I didn't know what it was, for years, and then found out it was Rocking Time, Burning Spear, which was actually one of my favourite all-time albums. And then through listening to a lot of, you know, people like, you know, Burning Spear and Peter Tosh and stuff like that, getting more and more into just like the kind of stripped down kind of, you know, version of reggae, which is dub, and, you know, the pioneers, people like King Tubby and the Scientist, who was like his assistant, who did a whole series of albums like Scientist Meets Space Invaders and stuff like that, which were incredible albums. But it was mainly just like listening to Tubby and the way that he kind of stripped things down to kind of bass and drums.